Mazda's product roadmap after Skyactiv X, diesel, rotary, hybrids, even EVs. When we first heard that Mazda had cleared the major hurdles on gasoline compression ignition, and were just tidying up the details with clear production intent, the first knee-jerk thought was, that's it for Mazda's consumer diesel. In particular, the Skyactiv-D that was intended for sale in the US, only to be delayed for years by various regulatory roadblocks and other issues that Mazda is frustratingly, but understandably, vague on. At least, it'd die out at some point down the road when Skyactiv X was widely available. It turns out that's not the case at all. Mazda will adopt an approach that becomes more and more electrified and diverse the closer you get to 2035. But internal combustion will play a deep and central role up to that point, and probably beyond. Before we get to what those different powertrains, diesel and electrified, will look like down the road, let's stop and think about Mazda's philosophy. It couldn't be more different from the approach of most manufacturers that are currently producing BEVs and hybrids, which are heavily incentivized by both the automakers and the government, both state and local, depending on the locality. Even with all that cash on top of the hood, the market penetration of electrified vehicles is low. Mazda's too small to lose money paying people to drive EVs and hybrids. Its risky solution, which is plucky, but has had mixed results, is to simply improve the internal combustion engine. It's achieved the best fleet average fuel economy in the US already, using a range of direct injection gas engines that are mostly naturally aspirated. A few tiny nods to electrification have been introduced, like IE loop regenerative braking and the Demio EV, a Japanese market, last generation Mazda 2 with a 20 kWh battery that was tested with a tiny rotary engine range extender. But the focus is on combustion, not electricity. And that focus isn't going away anytime soon. Mazda believes that pure gasoline, gasoline hybrid, and gasoline PHEV vehicles will remain the vast majority of vehicles sold through 2035. At that point, Mazda forecasts, BEV and fuel cell vehicles should make up about 15% of the total of Mazda's lineup. The remaining 85% will utilize some form of internal combustion engine. Now, that includes hybrids and even a small number of CNG LPG cars. And these are global numbers, as well. There may be even fewer fuel cell and CNG LPG vehicles sold here than abroad. The reason Mazda thinks it can rely almost solely on fossil fuel combustion for so long is the remarkable gains in efficiency it has made in the past few years. Skyactiv-G direct injection gasoline engines were introduced in the Mazda 3 in 2012. It beat its same displacement predecessor by a not insignificant 7 mpg highway/4 mpg city, thanks in part to a more efficient transmission that was part of the overall Skyactiv chassis and powertrain technology family. Basically, the 2012 Skyactiv engine was 15% more efficient than the MZR it replaced. The new Skyactiv X engine is a further 20-30% improvement to Skyactiv-G, Mazda claims. And here's the part Mazda is betting on. Starting with these very efficient combustion engines means when it finally has to turn to real hybrids, the benefits will stack. Mazda's Dave Coleman, at a backgrounder briefing on Skyactiv X technology, said that hybrids can leverage all of the internal combustion efficiency gains. Also, the per unit cost of high efficiency gas engine componentry seems to be less than the cost of adding hybrid technology to an individual vehicle. So says Mazda. This may be an assessment of the total life cycle of developing the technology. If you're starting from scratch, the R&D, tooling, and so forth will make each unit extremely expensive until the costs are amortized and the production processes scaled up. So when Mazda says it's cheaper for the company to focus on improving the internal combustion engine, that may be true for them. And were they to form a technological partnership with a company that has expertise in electrification, Toyota, and the unit cost assessment might flip entirely.